England Lions' four-pronged pace attack made life very difficult for the touring West Indians as they finally got a day's cricket in English conditions under their belts. After a delay of an hour, play began after James Taylor won the toss and asked the tourists to bat first. Adrian Barrath twice hit the ball over the slips for four. But he was also the first to fall when he fended off the back foot to a delivery from Jack Brooks, playing on his home ground in Northampton, into the hands of Nick Compton. Kieran Powell went in the next over as the West Indians began badly. He nicked Jay Dernbach behind on two. And when Ian Bell held on to a smart catch off Brooks to remove Kirk Edwards for a duck, West Indies had slipped to 16 for three. Enter Shivnarine Chanderpaul, a man who's got his side out of many scrapes in the past. He, though, found Brooks no easier to handle and was fortunate here. Stuart Meeker replaced his Surrey teammate Dernbach and immediately put the ball just in the right place to cause problems for Darren Bravo, who, like Chanderpaul, has had county experience at least. Kent's Matt Coles was brought on and his first wicket for the Lions was the big one off Chanderpaul, who got himself in a right muddle and chipped a simple catch to Brooks to go for six. The West Indians have had very little practice ahead of next week's first test and they now found themselves in some trouble on 29 for four. But Bravo, who had a spell with Nottinghamshire last season, showed that he is a man to watch in the forthcoming series. The left-hander keeps very still at the crease and played some crisp shots, especially through the offside. It was a tough start for the man from Trinidad, but once he settled in, he batted with some purpose and was the shining light on what was an otherwise gloomy day for his team. Bravo had made a 50 from 86 balls, but he then top-edged to pull off Mika to give Brooks his second catch of what was a memorable day for him. With Bravo out at 104 for 5, the rest of the innings folded fairly meekly. The impressive Meeker removed Marlon Samuels for 32 and he then bowled Shane Shillingford for a couple. Coles then struck for a second time by having Dennis Ramdin caught in the gully by Joe Root on 17 to lead the tourists on 131 for 8. 16 more runs were added to that before Brooks had Kemar Roach plumb in front for 13. And the innings was ended in the next over by Dernbach, who had Ravi Rampal taken behind by Johnny Bairstow. The West Indians have been bowled out for 147 inside 49 overs to delight the England hopefuls. Fidel Edwards then started with three no balls, the last one bowling Michael Carberry, but it didn't take Edwards too long to get it right, and when he did so, he proved to be too good for Root, although it was the horribly low bounce which really did the batsman. Carberry opened his scoring with a six off Rampal, the kind of bowler you would expect to do well in English conditions. Carberry looked a little edgy, but the same can't be said of Compton, the country's in-form batsman. He's made a wonderful start to this summer, and he's seemingly come from nowhere to be nudging the England selectors. He certainly has the credentials, although he did have a moment of fortune towards the end of this day when he nicked Roach through the slips for four. Carberry settled in before the close and he also struck a boundary to end the day on 15. The Lions had reached 40 for 1 when Bad Light took the players off with Compton on 18. Both batsmen will look to go on the second day to put their opponents under some pressure when they have to bat for a second time in this match.